you're going to repeat after me. I, state your full name.
Secretary of the Army Dr. Mark Esper administers the oath of enlistment to some of the Army's newest recruits. Secretary Esper was at Fort Meade recently meeting with Army recruiters. He also took questions from reporters. Highlights from that in just a moment. Also this week, some road work news. National Night Out is coming up and the Army's newest command. These stories and more, but first, as I mentioned earlier, Secretary of the Army Dr. Mark Esper stopped by the 1st Recruiting Brigade here at Fort Meade recently. After meeting with recruiters, administering the oath of enlistment to some new recruits, the secretary sat down and took some questions from reporters. Here are the highlights.
And so today was a chance to come up to Fort Meade, a little bit more local, and look at a particular part of the Army that I'm responsible for under my duties, and that's the man, train, and equip part. It's the man piece, and critical to that is understanding really well how we recruit young men and women into the service. I think this may be the first recruits I've sworn in. I swore in some other soldiers earlier today who were going through into the OCS branch. So today was probably my first day. It's a great opportunity for me, again, to take a measure of the talent, the quality we're bringing into the service. As you can see, the diversity of that talent. And the Army's a big Army. It reflects America. Every soldier is a recruiter and a diplomat by their own example and by the way they talk about their experiences in the service and the opportunities they see ahead. So that's why one of the initiatives we have right now is to bring soldiers back home to meet with their, to visit their schools or high schools, maybe the places they used to hang out, and talk about what they've experienced in the Army. Unvarnished, good and bad. Well, we're going to continue to grow year over year for the next several years. I know I need to be at least above 500,000 soldiers with associated growth in the Guard and Reserve. And as we fine tune what the future formations and the future Army will look like, I'll be able to give a better number, but that's some time away. But I know that we need to continue to grow it, so we'll grow this year. Next year, we're going to try and grow by another 4,000. And that'll probably be the pace we seek to set here for the coming years.
Meanwhile, in a related story, we just heard Secretary Esper talk about the future of the force. Just days ago, he announced the establishment of the Army Futures Command. He said the Army Futures Command will help fulfill the Army vision by addressing the key shortcomings of the acquisition system, providing unity of command, effort, and purpose to the entire modernization effort. The Futures Command, which began operations on July 1st, also announced last week that Austin, Texas had been selected as its home. The Army describes Austin as a location where it's better postured to be near innovative and agile industrial and academic institutions and where the command can foster the culture needed to lead the Army's modernization efforts. The Army also says there are three sub-organizations that will be established over the next several months before the command is fully established in 2019. Turning to local news, the parking lots outside the Civilian Personnel Office, the main post chapel, and the post theater are going to be completely repaved and restriped. The work is scheduled to start Monday, July 23rd, starting with the parking lot outside Civilian Personnel. As one is completed, contractors will move on to the next one. Drivers should be prepared for parking lot and road detours while the project is being completed. As always, your patience is greatly appreciated. In other news, one of the biggest community events of the year, National Night Out, is coming up Tuesday, August 7th. National Night Out was established in 1984 by the National Association of Town Watch. Held annually, the first Tuesday in August, National Night Out is meant to increase awareness about police and emergency services programs in the local community. Fort Meade's Directorate of Emergency Services has increased the size and scope of our National Night Out every year, winning multiple Best of awards along the way. Last year, however, Mother Nature intervened with gale force winds and a deluge of rain. National Night Out 2017 was canceled. National Night Out this year runs from 6 to 9 p.m. on McLaughlin Parade Field. The parade through base housing starts at 5. One other note, the Fort Meade Police and the Public Affairs Office invite you to download the Fort Meade app and play the app challenge. Details on that coming soon. In MWR news, the Fort Meade Family Pet Care Center suffered a fire in 2016 that reduced the number of kennels to 20, but MWR wants you to know that there are a variety of services still available. These a la carte services include outside playtime, one-on-one walks, couch time, and pet rewards. Center manager Tessa Turpin says they really want to make it a home away from home.
We love the dogs and we have a lot of fun, whether it's hanging out in their kennel or we offer couch time for the dogs to kind of chill out and get away from the kennel. And then our yards, we have 7 play yards and they all have pools and they can run and have fun.
And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.